Hi everyone, this is Nikki from Teen Services, and today I'm going to show you how to make a geeky craft. We will be making a Pikachu pom-pom, which you can actually rent the book from the library, and I highly recommend using it because it will help you while we do the tutorial. The materials you will need is a pom maker, or you can make one out of cardboard. Use the template inside to learn how to make it. Yellow and brown yarn. Craft glue that dries clear, felt needles, scissors, and felt in the colors yellow, red, brown, and black, black Sharpie, and embroidery black string. Did you know there are many different types of yarns you can buy, from natural yarn such as wool and cotton to synthetic like acrylic fiber? For this tutorial, look for either acrylic or wool yarn because you will get that plush looking pom. If you choose cotton, it will look stringy instead of plush, as seen in the photo that I made for Evie. Yarn also has many different types of weights, which refers to the thickness of yarn. For this tutorial, you can use weights numbered from 1 through 4. And from personal experience, you do not always have to follow the book exactly when it comes to their suggestions for yarn weight, color, and how many times you have to wrap the yarn, because it can lead to frustration, trust me. Just follow my suggested tips and you'll be fine. Now let's begin the tutorial. We will begin by making Pikachu's head. Take the top of the pom maker claws out and line them up evenly. Take the end of the yellow string and start wrapping it on the right side, making sure that it is snug. And keep wrapping until you get to the left side. Then you will want to continue wrapping fully until it looks like this. Tuck the under of the last string under another string and pull it tightly. Repeat what you just did for the bottom maker and it will look like this. Using sharp scissors, start cutting the middle of the string on the top and the bottom. Then, cut along another piece of string and tie it right down the middle, tying it tightly and do a double knot. This will secure it. Release the top and bottom of your claws and then pull apart the maker to reveal your pom and cut the extra excess string. For Pikachu's body, start with the top of the maker and start wrapping the yellow yarn about 12 times and then do the brown and wrap it about 12 times and then repeat yellow, brown, yellow. Finish wrapping the maker until it is full. Fill the bottom maker with only yellow yarn. Then repeat what you did to finish the pom. You are now done making both pom-poms. Now it is time to give your pom-poms a haircut. Grab a bowl so you can trim the poms evenly and not make a mess. You will notice a lot of yarn and fuzz will be cut. Don't worry, this is normal. Take the felt needle and stab around to cover and blend, especially the brown stripes. This will help make everything even and also make it more structured. Please be very careful and pay attention while using the felt needle. You do not accidentally want to stab yourself. Trimming can take time, so put on your favorite TV show. This is what the palms should look like afterwards. Take both of your palms and dab some glue right in the middle and glue them together so you have your body. Now trace using tracing paper or make a photocopy to cut out your felt pieces. And then assemble them together using the book as a guide to help you. Glue the tail right below the last brown stripe. You want to make sure that Pikachu is able to stand. Glue Pikachu's ears on the side of his head. For Pikachu's eyes, use white paint to paint little white dots at the top of the eyes. Using a toothpick, Place the eyes and also the red cheeks onto the face. For Pikachu's nose, use glue and embroidery thread to make his nose. Place glue on one end and let it dry so it hardens. After when it hardens, use a toothpick to place it right in the middle. Then, use your scissors to cut really close to the face so it looks like a black dot. For Pikachu's mouth, use a black Sharpie to marker the top of the template. Using a toothpick, spread some glue on the back. Then, fold it about halfway while also pressing the ends of the folds out, so it looks like a mouth. This is a tricky part, so you may have to make more than one. When placing the mouth, you want the fold to be facing down. And that's it. You have your cute Pikachu now. If you enjoyed this video, check out these other craft books that you can rent from the library or place a hold. You can also check out CreativeBug, a free library resource with your library card where you can learn new craft and art skills. Follow us on social media at Yuma Library on Facebook, Instagram, and this YouTube page, and make sure to subscribe. You can also check out our teen blog for more teen recommendations and also more do-it-yourself crafts at home. I hope you enjoyed this video, and thanks for watching.